I would now like to welcome Arl Edwards to the stage to perform our national anthem with Samantha Hoppe signing. Please rise and remove your caps.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
Thank you, Arl and Samantha. Welcome, Henrietta Lacks, Health and Bioscience High School Class of 2019, HeLa faculty members, friends, and family. We'd first like to thank and introduce the Evergreen School District Board of Directors, President Julie Bacanagra, Vice President Victoria Branford, Directors Ginny Gronwald, Rob Perkins, and Rachel Rogers. Thank you.
Class of 2019, I would now like to introduce School Superintendent Mike Merlino.
Thank you. First, I just want to say I really appreciate the opportunity to be here and speak tonight. And on behalf of myself and the school board, say congratulations to the seniors at HeLa and the class of 2019. Congratulations. Tonight is a celebration for the students. It's also a celebration for your families, your parents, your family, and your friends. And I also want to say we should give a round of applause to everybody, the families and friends representing the kids here as well. I also want to say that from my perspective, what this represents is a lot of hard work, that the students have put in, a lot of hard work that the administration has put in, a lot of hard work that the staff that's sitting in front has put in, and that's key, right? As you move forward in your future, you're gonna have a lot of opportunities and you're gonna have a lot of challenges. And I think if you move forward thinking about the fact that the hard work that can get you through everything that's gotten you to this point, it's gonna continue in the future. I also think along with the hard work, relationships are key. You've got many friends, you're sitting next to your friends, you're sitting next to your colleagues, and in the future, you're gonna have opportunities to create a lot of relationships with a lot of different people. I think if you really focus on positive relationships with those around you and hard work, you're gonna be very successful. You've got a bright future ahead of you. Thanks again for allowing me to speak, and congratulations and good luck.
Thank you, Mr. Merlino. I would now like to introduce class speaker, Anna Foyt.
Another year has gone by. Another set of grades, lessons, and lectures are over with. Crushes and drama are all done with. Honestly, this is not what I expected. I didn't expect these inside jokes, memories, and friends and teachers that feel like family. I feel so lucky to have the community connection of Gila High School. Here I've met hard workers, study partners, and leaders, some here by choice, some not, but what matters is that you are here now. Yesterday, some days are tough, but if the sun can rise and shine each and every day, so can we. So can everyone. We all grow and change and take risks one day at a time. Whether it's risking studying or winging it for a test, we all take part in taking risks. Sometimes you have to take a chance to get one. Today, there's no need to worry about the future. Let us enjoy this day, our day. Let us have hope. Hope we can make the medical field proud. Hope for each other and Gila students yet to come. May our passions lead us to discover joy. Joy in the fact that we can make a difference. Joy in the fact that we've made it this far. Together here today, we have overcome challenges of our own in spite of the imperfections of everyday life. Like phoenix from the ashes, we spread our wings and rise above. You may feel at this point like your wings are too tattered and too weak to take flight, looking forward at an uncertain journey to come. But wings were made for flying, and no one can stop you from doing what you're meant to do. Yes, everyone can find their purpose. Even you, sir, in the back. Everyone has heard a story along the lines that if you give a man a fish, he'll eat for a day. And then if you give a teacher man a fish, he'll eat for a lifetime. The same principle applies to the virtue of compassion. If you give him compassion, he'll be happy for a day. If you teach him compassion, he'll be happy for a lifetime. Compassion is the effort and concern to help others. It's what the school was designed for, isn't it? Whether it's programs like bioengineering, nursing, or pharmacy, the point of it all is to help humanity in one way or another. Our medical-based careers will help others and build character of our own and build strength in our hearts. I know this because I've seen it happening in you guys. Through helping set up prom and other events and being involved in maintaining the school spirit. No, school spirit is not that random ghost that lurks around the hallways, but is the happy vibe and excitement that students give off. You know what I'm talking about. Let me hear, guys. The kindness I've seen in my fellow students grows one step at a time as you give effort and time to others. Every year for the past 4 years, I've seen it grow one step at a time. Sometimes it takes several steps, much like completing the journey to the third floor, but it is starting that matters. It doesn't matter how we start out, but who we become is what's important. Time was slow up until sophomore year, if I'm honest. But it's gone faster since then. So much faster, I ended up here somehow. So I'll end here with only one reasonable complaint about high school. It's that once you start to enjoy and cherish the moments, then you know it's almost time to leave. Congratulations, class of 2019, we did it!
Thank you, Anna. And now I would like to introduce class speaker Ramiz Tanous.
Oh boy. Well, I'd like to start off by saying good afternoon, teachers, faculty, parents, and my amazing classmates for what is so far an all right day. Today marks an incredible milestone of our lives. And all of you should be proud that you survived all of those 6 a.m. alarms to see this day happen. This is tough. When I was asked by Ms. DeWine to try to speak at graduation, I thought she was joking. I was daunted with the task of summarizing the last four amazing years into speech no more than 6 minutes. My head flooded with memories and moments that will never be simulated through a speech. I can never truly explain how much of a journey we have made from just attending the same school. My father once told me, "Rifqatak bil ayam al hilwa ma nun mit rifqatak bil ayam al sabe." And if you haven't taken 6 years of Arabic, you probably don't understand that. So I'll happily translate. He said, "Friendships formed through the hard times are 1,000 times stronger than those formed through easy times." And I never truly understood that as much as I do now. 4 years ago, we walked through Hila's doors not knowing what to expect. We all came here seeking something different, whether it was the different high school experience or the different classes or our parents forced us, which I'm sure a lot of my classmates can relate to. We were lost freshmen looking for a clue of what to do next, and with heavy backpacks and schedules in hand, we started the path to graduation. Many diverged from this path, and we lost beloved friends, teachers, friends, and the bathroom doors. Regardless, that never stopped us. We made many mistakes, and that was just part of the experience. We had many letdowns and obstacles, like Mr. Gundert not letting us blow stuff up in his chemistry lab because it's a safety hazard. Okay. We endured lectures and exams and fought hard to hang on, just to do it again the next day. Many great lessons were learned from this, not the least of which is that the grades and the symbolic gestures were never the true reward, but the person you have become through the harsh process of acquiring them. 6 years ago, when I moved here from Syria, I struggled with leaving much of my family behind. But I find a new family right here, the people I shared the hard and good times with, the people I believe will change the world to the better.
We love you!
Because when I look around my graduating class, I don't see just faces and names. I see the next entrepreneur, the next CEO, the next humanitarian, the next clothing designer, the next soldier, and the list goes on and on. I see nothing but potential in my graduating class, because if anyone believes in my class in changing the world, it's me. It may be the Board of Education, I don't know if they're still on that boat. Throughout high school, I learned that if you want it, believe in it, work in it, and make the sacrifices necessary, your goal will come true, and no one can say otherwise. When things get hard, don't drop the ball. Stay focused, and you will do fine. Try new things and do what others are too scared to do. Be the person you needed when you were weak and needed guidance and help. Look around you and ask yourself, what do people need that your skill or talent can provide? It's easy to say that high school was the worst and how much we just wanted to get it over with. But many years from now, when we look back at our high school years, we'll realize just how important those years were in the rest of our lives, how it shaped us into what we are today. The things we'll remember the most won't be what we wore to school or how many followers we had on social media. It won't be what your grades were like, and it might be the amount of stairs that made every graduating senior capable of squatting a Prius. It'll be the kind of person you were, the connections you made along the way, and the way you treated everyone around you. It will be the contributions that impacted others around you, and it will definitely be the adult you have become walking out of those double doors for the last time that will be remembered. I am extremely proud of my fellow classmates and honored to be part of this graduating class. Of course, none of this would have been possible without the unconditional love of your parents and the support of Hila's staff. One final thank you to the people responsible for everything I have accomplished by being here today, my amazing parents, whose sacrifices made me become everything that I ever wanted to do in life. Thank you for everything. That being said, graduating class of 2019, thank you for making the last 4 years of my life some of the best so far. I will miss all of you very much, and I wish you nothing but the best and good luck. And this is for Walker. Dilly dilly. Thank you.
Thank you, Ramiz. And now here's Samantha Allen performing Vienna, accompanied by Kendallin Hudson.
Thank you, Samantha and Kendallin. I would now like to introduce a student speaker, Nicole Nugent.
Hi, everyone. My name is Nicole Nugent. I would like to start off by thanking the teachers, the administrative staff, and the student body of Gila High School, as well as my friends and my family for supporting me throughout my high school education. I wouldn't have accomplished all I did if it wasn't for your hard work, dedication, support, and compassion. I would also like to send my congrats to the class of 2019. Today marks a big accomplishment for all the graduates. You should all be proud of yourselves, the legacy you left behind at Gila, and all you accomplished as students of Gila High. I remember my freshman year. I was even shorter than I am now. My backpack probably weighed 50 pounds, which we all know is an underestimate, and the Gila halls seem like a maze I would never navigate, especially the stairwells. I came to high school without a clear mission, as many of you, and there was a big question mark in front of every decision that shaped my future. Today, I have a vision for the future with the same big question marks. But after the experiences I have had in my 4 years of being a student at Gila High, I know that that is how the future is supposed to be. Unexpected, spontaneous, and completely unpredictable. I spent the majority of my life planning everything, from how many AP classes I was going to take, to what colleges I was going to apply for, to what degree I would eventually pursue. But the more plans I made, the more I limited myself from discovering passions I never knew I had, and the more I lost sight of the true meaning to my life. I realized that knowing what we want for our lives is more than declaring a major or choosing to join the military. It is deciding how we want to impact the world and how we want to spend the time that life grants us. So, don't choose a major, choose a passion. Don't choose a career, choose an opportunity to make your mark on the world. And when you do find the path you want to follow and the dreams you want to pursue, whether it's tomorrow or 10 years down the line, it doesn't matter. Never give up, never lose hope, and never lose your authenticity. For the past 3 years, I have cooked Sunday dinner at the Sharehouse Women's and Family Homeless Shelter. Through this experience, I have met inspiring people and could spend hours talking about each and every one of them. From a father of three who came after work at his auto body shop to clean the restrooms and mop the floors and do the jobs that nobody wanted to do, to a family of four that became homeless because they couldn't afford their medical bills. But today, I want to tell you about the story of a lady that was living at the share house about a year ago. She was older, homeless, and battling an aggressive form of cancer. There wasn't a lot she could eat in the shelter because the pantries and fridges were only stocked with whatever people could donate, which rarely included expensive things like fish and fresh greens, let alone a working blender. So as a volunteer, I felt a responsibility to do my best to make sure that everyone in the shelter got an amazing dinner. But I couldn't provide that for her. And in a way, I felt that I failed her and my responsibilities. Even though I knew no matter what I did, I couldn't fix the bigger problem, which was her battle with cancer. This feeling of failing and letting people down is something we will experience time and time again in our futures as healthcare professionals when we lose a patient, or as educators when we reach a roadblock with a student. But it was in this feeling of failure that I discovered a life-changing lesson: the importance of the impact we have on the people around us far exceeds the importance of the titles that we achieve. I gave my time to cooking for the shelter, but if I didn't help this woman or try my best every day and every shift to put a smile on people's face with a great meal, then what was the purpose of me being at the shelter at all and calling myself a volunteer cook? With this revelation, I pushed aside the idea that there was nothing I could do to help her and found the one way I knew I could. I remembered when my dad was going through chemotherapy that my mom would make him smoothies and juices, and that was something I genuinely wished I could do for the woman at the shelter because I knew that it helped my dad. So I bought a new blender for the kitchen. And although this act was small, it was my way of telling her that I was more than just a volunteer. I was someone who truly cared for her and wanted nothing more than to see her living her best and healthiest life. So ask yourself today, who do you want to be? What type of career do you want to have? What do you want to be remembered for? Many of you are going on to pursue college degrees or going to technical schools or entering the workforce. But whatever it is that you're doing after you leave the halls of Gila High School, never allow these milestones, degrees, and accomplishments to define you. Find success by letting your actions speak for themselves. I hope that each one of the graduates will take from this story that you can do anything, and I mean anything, as long as you pursue making an impact rather than achieving titles, never giving up, and always, always believing in yourself. Some of you think I'm smart, but I'm not. I do know, though, that I am 100% a hard worker. I am not gifted, but I am a dreamer. And we are all not perfect, but we are all survivors of our own life's trials and tribulations. And the journey we are about to embark on is stressful, but exciting. We are probably going to feel overwhelmed in the beginning, like freshman year all over again. But never lose yourself to the stresses that life will surely bring. In high school, I allowed the stress and pressure to control my life, and I landed in the emergency room this past January as a result, because my body went into shock from sleep deprivation. The ER doctor told me something important, though, that day that turned my life around for the better. He said, "The lack of sleep, the hard work, the added plates of pressure isn't worth it, because it doesn't matter what school you get into, what degree you get, or what you accomplish, if you're going to come out not knowing who you are and who you want to be. Only with balance can you achieve what you really want in life, and sometimes what you really want is not what you are pursuing at all. My mom always taught me to never give up on my goals, but never allow myself to be the cost of my achievements. It took a trip to the emergency room for me to finally listen, but you can listen today. I want every graduate to know that they can change the world and will change the world, no matter how small or how big you think your actions are. It's just a matter of when. Never limit yourself by trying to live the way society deems is right. Write your own path and dive into the scariest, most daunting waters that you can find. And I know it may be scary, I'm scared too, and it's a big task to swallow, but no matter how hard it is to write our own paths and how hard it is to follow it, we are all born to run in the directions of our dreams. In fact, it's our destiny. And despite the challenge, if we can take it, we will always make it. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicole. I would now like to introduce our final student speakers, Asante Johnson and Rianne Del Carmen.
Good evening, Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School class of 2019.
Before we begin, we'd like to take the time to thank everyone who is here today.
This is a special day for each and every one of our graduates, so thank you for being here to celebrate with us.
The accomplishments we've made these past 4 years are a reflection of wisdom, time, and unconditional support given to us from all of you.
Asante and I would like to give a special thank you to each of our parents for endlessly supporting our dreams and all the sacrifices they made for us.
Thanks, Mom and Dad. Thank you to all the teachers and amazing staff of Gila for guiding us. We wouldn't be who we are today without you. 4 years ago, we all made the decision to come to Gila. We came as individuals from different middle schools, bringing our own sets of unique talents and personalities. It didn't take long for us to unite as one, to make Gila our home, a place that prepared us for our future.
not just as doctors, researchers, or nurses, but as a student, a friend, and a member to our community. Hila taught us more than just chemical bonding or CPR training. They also taught us what it truly means to rise above.
If you ask a graduate what rising above means to them, each will have a different answer. To me, it means to put others before myself, to offer help even when not asked for. For others, it means to persevere through any obstacle or to do the right thing even when you are the only one doing so. We are standing here because we have all risen in our own ways.
Looking back to freshman year, it's remarkable how much we have all changed. In between our freshman and senior year, we have experienced our own highs and lows. We've changed ideologies, learned to embrace the unfamiliar, we've loved and we've lost. There were moments that shook us to our cores and moments we wish would last forever. The euphoria of prom night, the all-nighters before a deadline, the excitement of our first paychecks, and the nervousness of college admissions. Moments like those, they shaped us. Perhaps a spark of curiosity ignited within you these past 4 years. Or maybe you're still searching for that one thing that fires passion within you. Regardless, it is certain. Our class of 2019 walked through the doors of Henrietta Lacks High School 4 years ago, determined to leave our mark. It burned within us to create a lasting legacy. That desire has and will never fade away, because standing here today are 129 proud graduates embarking on a journey to change the world in their own little way.
Today, we'll leave here with friendships and relationships that we'll cherish forever. Who knows where life will take us? Some of us don't even know ourselves, and that's okay. Our very own graduate, Stephen Deary, once said, "You don't have to know where you're going. Just stick true to your values and beliefs, and you'll turn out just fine." We will all take separate paths in lives, whether it's to the military, becoming a doctor, backpacking Europe, researching the next cure to a disease, or starting a family. But always remember who you are and where you came from.
So graduates, as we stand here today with the world in our hands, remember to build the life that you want to live. Keep moving forward, seize the next opportunity, and pursue the dreams that you set your heart to. Believe in yourself, just like our parents and our teachers believe in us. Do not forget what being a phoenix is and what Rise Above means for you. For even though your time here at Hila may have been temporary, you will always have a place to call home.
Thank you, Asante and Rianne. I would now like to introduce our principal, Julie Tumblety, to present the class of 2019.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, faculty members, and especially the graduates of class of 2019. Graduates, as you know, our school motto is Rise Above. You've heard it many times tonight. We say this a lot, and we strive to embrace it in our actions. But what does it really mean to rise above? For some, this could mean pushing ahead of the pack, striving to get to the top, competing, and standing out to look better than others. But class of 2019, this is not how you embody this expression. When you rise above, you first strive to be the best version of yourself. You work harder than you thought you could. You challenge yourself, you take risks, you enroll in one of our pathways that you never thought about before. You join a club and end up competing at the state level. Your leadership becomes an example to others. At Hila, Rising Above is also about service to others, whether that is to your peers, your patients, or the greater community. Class of 2019, as a group, you have devoted thousands of hours to formal community service, such as serving the homeless in downtown Portland or volunteering with families at Peace Health. The motto is also reflected in the small and daily acts, such as writing a kind note of encouragement to a classmate or telling a teacher you appreciate them. You rise above by lifting others. Wherever your journey takes you in your next steps, remember that there will be difficult times, you will have stress, challenges, and obstacles. In these moments, remember that an act of service for someone else is the best way for you to gain perspective, move forward, and create positive momentum. You made the choice to join our HeLa family and focus on health, healing, and care for others. I am confident that you will continue to serve those around you with a core of kindness and compassion, rising above and making the world a better place. And now to the real reason why you all came here tonight. As principal of Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School, it is my privilege to confirm that these students receiving their diplomas have met the requirements of the state of Washington and the standards set forth by Evergreen School District. Members of the Board of Directors, Superintendent Mike Merlino, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience Class of 2019. It is my honor to present the diplomas to the 2019 senior class officers. Rianne Del Carmen. Kendalyn Hudson. Namrata Prasad. Amelia Ball. Brooke Billier. Bridge Bynum. Stephen Deary. Callie Dorzinski. Willie Ha. Mia Levy. Kevin Nguyen.
Christia Salmo. Mary Smith. Tyler Yoon. Elijah Adrian. Brian Alonzo Flores. Natasha Altamirano. Andrea Avendano. Philip Beriak. Catherine Bates. Alma Baitich. Elvin Burkich. Alyssa Brooks. Yeah. Alam Burakovich. Clarissa Camacho Corona. Carson Carruthers.
Miguel Chavez. Alyssa Sharape. Aaron Clevenger. Jason Kajikaru. Walker Coulson. Leonardo Contreras. Sean Crowder. Tabitha Adidas. Christina Dorblalisha. Alicia Donsey. Emma Durovov. Timothy Devenchka.
Chloe Doyle. Kimberly De Leon. Christina Dietrich. Bianca Dringenberg. Amy Durant. Arl Edwards. Brandon Ellinger. Corbin Fletcher. Morgan Gibb. Lisa Grover. Rena Grover. Hannah Hambleton.
Ian Hanley. Alex Harlan. Emily Hernandez Contreras. Zion Hill. William Hoka Nettle. Emily House. Samantha Hoppe. Tare Isidro. Drew Iverson. Autumn Johnson. McKenna Johnson. Tristan Jordan.
Alex Kennedy. Meredith Kruger. Victoria Lakatosh. Sahara Nicole Ledoux. Emily Longrath. Riley Moss. Rayanna Manning. Casey Marlowe. Griffin Martinez. Dexter Massey. Anna Merzanina. Colleen McCarrig. Jonathan Melhorn. Zach Moyer. Alexi Mitchell.
Litzy Montez. Leanna Merzak. Kunga Nepali. Christopher Nikoloff. Tenzin Norden. Hannah Noyes. Deanna Pankratov. Aaron Parr. Victoria Pavlova. Daria Pisarchuk. David Prushenshuk. Molly Rasmussen. Austin Reeves.
Oscar Reyes Cortez. Andre Rivera. Olivia Russell. Christian Salazar. Sahil Sharin. Anna Shimolina. Elizabeth Spack. Janatavir Singh. Franklin Solomon Ludrix.
Catherine Soto. Janessa Stott. Declan Starr. Bryce Tautfest. Odelia Tachenko. TJ Tran. Hong Trong. Right. Joseph Tully. Cole Urbach. Christian Valdez Martinez. Ashley Walm. Jaden Wright. Jasmine Wright. Samantha Yan. Erica Yevon. Julie Zelichenko.
Anna Foyt. Ramiz Tanous. Samantha Allen. Asante Johnson. Nicole Nugent.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you our graduating class of Henrietta Lacks Health and Bioscience High School. Will you all please stand up? Or students only, sorry. Class of 2019, you may turn your tassels. Woo! Conclude this evening's ceremony, we would once again like to thank all of you for being here tonight to share this moment with class of 2019. For those of you heading to the grad party or back to Gila, buses will load by Cascade Middle School immediately following the ceremony. Thank you, everyone. Hope you all stayed dry and have a good night.